Here's a computer that's been a star of my channel for a while, the ThinkPad T60. I really like this computer, but I haven't been using it a lot lately, because I took the solid state drive that was in it and put it in my ThinkPad T410. Last time I had the SSD in this T60, it was January 2021, and there was Windows 7 installed on it. I made a backup, then removed the SSD from this T60, put it in the T410, erased it, and installed other operating systems. But now I put the SSD back in here, and I'm going to try restoring that backup. So let's see what's going to happen when we boot up a Windows installation that hasn't been touched for over a year. So I made the backup with Macrium Reflect. To restore it, I'm going to use this bootable disk I made with the program. At first, it seems like it's not doing anything, but it's actually loading. Then we'll see the Windows boot screen. I know this is an older version of Macrium Reflect, but it was the latest one back when I made this disk. And here we are. First of all, we want to erase the SSD. Just to be safe, so I'll open the command prompt and use DiskPart. Let's list the disks. There's only the SSD, so we'll select it. And to erase everything on it, you just type clean. There we go. Now I'll plug in my external hard drive, which has the backup. And go to browse for an image file. Here's the external hard drive and T60 backup. Here it is. This backup is from January 9th, 2021. So just over a year ago. And we want to restore it to the internal SSD, but I think it hasn't refreshed the cleanup stuff I've done to it, so. There we go, now it recognizes it's empty. Let's restore it. Make sure we select the right disk. Okay, now that's a bit concerning, since it's the same disk. Maybe there is a few differences between the Windows 7 version of the program and the Windows 10 version, because this bootable disk uses Windows 10 pre-installation environment. But we'll select use the source disk geometry, because it is the same PC. As you can see, the disk of the backup and the current disk are the same, so not sure what happened there. But we'll try it anyway. Copy selected partitions, and it looks about right. We'll check each partition anyway. Alignment, Vista 7 or SSD, that's good. I had about 72 gigabytes used, but the backup was only around 44 gigabytes, so that's compression for you. And we can review everything, and it will do SSD trim as well. Well, we can check the advanced options. We don't need this, it doesn't work on the free version anyway. Yes, enable trim. No need to verify, the backup is already done, and I did verify it during the backup process. And replace with the master boot record from the backup. Recommended. So let's go. This will take a while because it's using USB 2, so I'll come back when it's done. Okay, now it's done. It took just under 37 minutes. So now let's shut down. I'll remove the DVD and the external hard drive. And now let's try starting up. Okay, this is taking a bit longer. And there it is, starting Windows. Let's see if it recognizes my fingerprint. It does, so my finger hasn't changed much in a year. We get the Windows 7 is out of support message. And there it is, just as I left it a year ago. Right now it's offline. I have the wireless switch set to off, so it's not connecting to the internet. But if everything's working fine, we can connect. Oh, I can't wait for it to sync a year's worth of Dropbox stuff. And here it's saying that the CPU is hot, but it's already cooled down to 70 degrees, 60 now, Celsius of course. So that's another reason why I haven't been using this computer a lot. Because of the ATI graphics card, sometimes it heats up a lot, and I'm afraid it could overheat. But it's already cooled down, and I've got a laptop cooler under it. So here we have it. Got the classic theme on here, and here are the specs. The Windows Experience Index. The SSD is 7.1 instead of 7.9 because it's only SATA 1 speed. This computer doesn't support anything faster, but it's still really fast. Let's check out the web browsers. It looks like you haven't started Firefox in a while, you don't say. And let's see what version it was. 78.6.1. What's the latest version of Firefox ESR now? I believe 91. And how about Microsoft Edge? To be honest, I don't remember using Edge on this computer. It was automatically installed by Windows Update. And that one's version 87. It says copyright 2022, but I haven't connected it to the internet yet, so that must just say the current year. And I had the charge threshold set up, but because I plugged it in without the OS with the charge threshold set, it didn't know that there were these thresholds, so it charged to 100%. So I'd have to discharge it and then plug it in while this OS is running in order to limit the charge between 60 and 75%. Core temp warns me when the CPU temperature is above 90 degrees, but it will cool down soon. And I did replace the thermal paste on this computer about 2 years ago, so it should be good enough. As you can see, it's already cooled down. Let's see Windows Update. Last update check, January 8th, 2021. It was basically just Microsoft Security Essentials virus definitions. Yep, intelligence security update for Microsoft Security Essentials. And also it updated Microsoft Office, and malicious software removal tool. Because since January 2020, there have been no more security updates. And I initially installed this version of Windows in February 2018, but the Windows update history only goes back to September of that year. So I know Windows 7 is unsupported, but like I've already said, this is not my main computer. My main computer does run Windows 10. But I actually used this T60 with this Windows 7 installation as my main computer for a whole semester of university, using MATLAB and some Java stuff. Back then I used Eclipse. And it did work pretty well. That was in early 2018. I did sometimes use my more powerful computers, but most of the work I did for my exams in that semester were done on this computer. So I'm happy about that. Anyway, I have to decide if I'm gonna keep this installation. Just in case someone else in my family needs the T410, I have to put the SSD back in it. So I either have to buy another SSD or take the SSD out of this one again. I've made a decision. I just bought a few more SSDs, so now this T60 and my other computers can have them. I think we're now ready to connect to the internet and see what's gonna happen. It's been over a year, so there's gonna be a lot of data flowing. But with some patience, it should catch up. Because it's Windows 7, it won't catch up with a lot of updates. Because it's Windows 7, it doesn't have to catch up with a lot of updates. So, are we ready? I'm gonna flick the switch. Okay, it's connected. You couldn't see it from there, but there we go. You can see the wireless light is blinking now. It's already syncing Dropbox. CPU usage has gone to 100%. Right now, the app that's using the most CPU is Dropbox. Of course, it has to sync that stuff. And also, anti-malware service executable. I guess it's updating the definitions for it. And here we have an error. You haven't signed into OneDrive. Well, I guess it's been a while, so it has to reauthorize it. I'll do it another time. The virus and spyware definitions were created 427 days ago. So it hasn't updated yet, but it will. And it seems like Dropbox is still working. In addition to syncing my files, it also has to update itself. Has Windows Update checked for updates yet? No, but I'll let it do that automatically. How about Firefox? Can we update that? It also has to sync with my Firefox account. Has to update the browser, the add-ons, everything. Let's see, can't check for updates automatically, important. Well, you can't check for updates when the computer's turned off and offline. Oh, now it's checking for updates. So yeah, this is pretty much what I expected. It has to sync and update a lot of stuff, but otherwise it just works normally. So we have 14 important updates and one optional update. Oh, Office update. And of course, Microsoft Security Essentials update. And Windows Malicious Software Removal Tool, as useful as it is. The optional update is a preview update from January 2020, so I don't think I should install that. So yeah, not many updates since the OS is out of support. Okay, it took a while, but now there's less CPU activity, so let's restart Firefox. Then we'll install the Windows updates. And there we have it, Firefox with the new Proton user interface. Which looks worse, but it's tolerable. Still prefer using Firefox over other web browsers. There it is, version 91.7. So I'm gonna back out of this, just in case it installed some other updates in the background, and then look at the updates list again. As you can see, the Microsoft Security Essentials definitions update is gone because it already installed it automatically. Now the definitions are from 2022. Also, another important program to update is Macrium Reflect. Let's see the current version that's installed here. And when you have the classic theme, it has this bizarre looking Windows XP style in the title bar, but it works fine. So here's the updater, lots of updates to catch up on. And now there's even version 8 of Macrium Reflect, but I'm still using version 7 on all of my computers. So let's download this minor update for version 7. And once everything is settled, I can make a new backup. And there it is, but I'll just say later. Now let's install the Office and Malware Removal Tool updates. It already downloaded them, so it's gonna install them now. And there we have it. Because these updates were not for the OS itself, we don't even need to restart. And I'm sure there are other programs that need to be updated, but I'm not gonna show every single one of them. So there it is, the T60 shining again with Windows 7. Like I've shown in a video a few years ago, newer versions of Windows don't run very well on this specific T60. Because of issues with the ATI video driver. However, modern Linux distributions do run well, so I may try some. So that's about it. Thank you for watching.